Thermal comfort is more than air temperature. In this video, we will explore what is thermal comfort. Thermal comfort is a balance of heat transfer between our body and our surroundings. When heat is removed too fast from our body, we will feel cold. When heat is removed too slowly from our body, we will feel hot. All heat transfer mechanism is at work: convection, evaporation, conduction, and radiation. Convection is air movement that removes heat from our body. Evaporation, our body perspires all the time. We are sweating even in an air-conditioned room. This is why in a dry room, we will feel more comfortable. Conduction, if I'm wearing a jacket, the heat will be conducted slowly out of a jacket and I will feel warmer. Finally, radiation. Radiation occurs between two surfaces of different temperature. A hot surface will radiate to a cold surface. If you are sitting in a room with a hot window, we will feel the radiation of heat from the window to us even though the air temperature is low. An important terminology in thermal comfort is operative temperature. And operative temperature is the average of air temperature and mean radiant temperatures. Simply add these two temperatures together and divide it by two. The air temperature is the dry bulb temperature of the air surrounding us. The mean radiant temperature is the average surface temperature that is surrounding us. The walls, the ceiling, the floors, the lights, the TVs, basically any object that is surrounding us, hotter or cooler. If it's hotter, that heat will radiate to our body. If it's colder, our body heat will be radiated towards that object. Our body is constantly exchanging heat radiation with these surfaces around us. Depending on the space type, we have an expectation of comfort. If we are sitting in an office environment, we expect air-conditioned environment of 22 to 25 degrees Celsius. If we are sitting at a naturally ventilated space, our expectation of thermal comfort increases up to 29 to 30 degrees Celsius. The first tool to be introduced is PPD2. This tool is used for air-conditioned space like an office. This tool is very comprehensive and involves heavy computation. It addresses air temperature, air speed, mean radiant temperature, relative humidity, type of clothes worn, and the type of activities. Heavy computation is done by computers, and there are many websites offering such PPD computation. One of the more popular ones is listed here, provided by Berkeley. Do visit it and give this tool a try. The second tool is adaptive thermal comfort. This tool is primarily used for naturally ventilated spaces. This tool is called adaptive because it assumes that in a naturally ventilated environment, we are smart enough to adapt to our environment. We know we should not be wearing a jacket if the outdoor is hot. We also know that we should look for a place with good airflow, shaded, drink cold water, and so on. Do take note that this tool ignores relative humidity. There are indications that the lower relative humidity increases acceptable operative temperatures. As a rule of thumb, this tool is conservative for a hot and dry environment. The last tool to be introduced is elevated airspeed for thermal comfort. This tool says that it is possible to feel comfortable up to 30 degrees Celsius with an airspeed of 1.2 meters per second, that is, sitting underneath a ceiling fan. There are a few free tools on the internet that is quite good. I recommend looking up climate consultant and Andrew March psychometric chart. These tools analyze thermal comfort based on our climatic conditions and propose solutions to enhance our thermal comfort according to our climate. There have been some quite innovative developments in personal cooling in recent years. Instead of cooling the entire room, we just need to cool ourselves. A personal fan on the desk or ceiling fan is always a good option for personal cooling. Another good option is personal evaporative cooling fan. Water is poured into a container and evaporated by a small fan. Still in research and development, there are personalized radiant cooling panels, and phase change jacket. High humidity is bad for evaporation. Low humidity is good for evaporation. We will feel more comfortable at lower humidity than higher humidity because sweat from our body evaporates easier. In addition, low humidity is perfect for evaporative cooling. Finally, something for us to think about. Our skin temperature on our body, range from 31 to 33 degrees Celsius. If the outdoor air temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, will you be cool or heated by outdoor air?